Greetings, fellow worldlings. We are currently in Orsinium, right in front of, well, Gortwog's palace here. And we intend to go in and essentially ask Gortwog about this, well, dust that Medora had been talking about in our vision. So Medora came to me in a vision and told me that Lysandus' host could be soothed if I had can convince Gortwog, Lord of the Orcs, in Orsinium to tell me where it is. So yeah, we need him to sort of persuade him in the orcish fashion. If you catch my drift. Now, the thing is, as soon as we enter this place, somebody will be attacking us. I just hope it's not another Orsinium crawl. Like, this guy is gonna attack us anyway, so he's like aggro towards us by default. What about you there? I hope you're all peaceful? Yes, you are. Okay, time to talk to Gortwog. So Medora wants the Dust of Restful Death. Yep, that's the name of the quest. Only because I respect the memory of King Lysandus will I do this. The dust can be found in the ruins of Gaerhart Farmstead on her own island. Tell Medora that the price is her support to my claim to the heart. She'll know what it means. Oh, so this is where we get the entry. I see. This is where we... where Gortwog enters the political fray. I hope that got logged into my... yeah, it did. Into my logbook. The Gaerhart Farmstead, Isle of Balfiera. I guess we traveled there then. Is this the Gaerhart Farmstead? You know what? Okay. Buckwing Farmstead. Yom House, whatever. Direnni Tower. Singberry. Kingston. Blackhead. Upvale. Yom Heart Graveyard. Heartsmith Farmstead. Yeah, I can't find any by that name. Wait, let me just check whether Gaerhart. Oh, just a single A, right. Gaerhart Farmstead. But did he not? Where's this place supposed to be? I'm not looking for towns, I'm looking only for dungeons. Yomhart Graveyard. Ashton Crypts. Ruins of the Gaerhart Farmstead, of course. Of course. I'm fortified, the entrance should be somewhere over here. And... well, let's hope that this dungeon is kind to us, that we do not have to roam around a ton. I think this is just one of the procedurally generated dungeons, actually. So I think it should be fine. I think the entrance should be somewhere in here. No? Okay. I guess it's up to us to figure out where the entrance is. Good thing I have my mace out. In case someone tries to do something, but oh, there it is. Oh, that's the literal hole in the wall. Okay, this dungeon looks ominous, but wish me luck. Hey, can I not go into it? I can. Cool. From the looks of it, I've got only one way to go. Actually, there is a hidden door in front of me. No? Oh, that's the dungeon entrance, right. So, from the looks of it, yeah, I do have only one way to go here. Oh, no, 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 what is that? What the hell was that? What the hell was that? Excuse me. Yeah, that was sort of unfair, to be honest. That thing is still there. I'm gonna pop in a few potions here. Resist shock, and I think he was using fire spell, so I'm just gonna use a potion of resist fire as well. Because I don't know. Oh, wait, that's a different thing. That is not the same thing that I had just encountered. I just wasted a few of my potions here. That's sad. That is sad. That is really sad. Oh well. Actually, you know what? Let me just go ahead and reload because I do not have the resources to waste on, you know, base like this, essentially. If we see him again, then we'll pre-pop these potions. It's a wraith this time. Sorry, a ghost. And the ghost has died. So this dungeon module, I've seen it before. I would like to say that I'm mostly familiar with it, but then again, you know how these things go. Oh, just another ghost. No, it was a wraith this time. Not a ghost. Okay. Cool. Let's go this side then. I mean, this is more or less a circular sort of dungeon module. It has a looping structure to it. Okay, hold up. I need to pop in a few potions here. Resist fire first and foremost, and then resist shock. Because I don't know what kind of spells you're gonna be tossing at me. Of course I'm paralyzed. Reaction anywhere? Okay, I need to heal as well, in addition to doing all of that. Ancient Lich. And a Lich. So that guy was an ancient lich, and this is a lich. I thought that liches were probably the most powerful enemies in this game, but turns out there is one that is even stronger than a lich. It's called an ancient lich. And I just hope that this was the only one in the game, because otherwise I would be pissed. I mean, I wouldn't be pissed, I would be in a world of hurt, to be honest. Okay, so this area leads to a dead end, which essentially just leaves us with only one place to go, to be honest. From what I can see, there aren't many places we can go then, except for this path right here. Huh. I see another one of you guys, and I would like to encounter you before. Ooh, good to see that these guys actually still do die to their own spells. So I'll save here again, because that was a successful encounter, and I'll drop a few things here, just to denote the fact that I have started coming here. Now if this is going where I think it is going, our objective might just be towards this area here. Oh no, this is just like an accessory room. That was a sitting wraith. It's quite difficult to actually see these wraiths, the ones that are sitting, I mean. I recall the soundtrack. It's one of the more tense soundtracks from Arena. Arena had like some of the tenser soundtracks. This soundtrack always gets me anxious. Always. Without exception. That sounds like a skeleton, and I hope it is a skeleton. And not one of those. Ah, yes. This is the module that I was looking for. Or was I? Let's go left and see what's in store for us. What kind of punishment is in store for us. Oh. Just a human. I got scared there for a second. I was wondering what's gonna pop around the corner, to be honest. Okay, we need to get a better... I need to get a better vantage point on you. Ooh, that is fancy. Mithril Saber. Look at you. Yeah, that's it. I'm gonna save here. Like, saving often in this game is highly recommended. Otherwise, you may find yourself losing progress. So these guys are fine. Whenever I hear any of these guys making a noise, I think to myself that I'm fine for the most part. Okay, time to pop in a few potions here. Potion of resist fire and a potion of resist shock. No, I think fire should be enough, because I think even these guys, for the most part, just do fire spells. Yeah, I think that was good. Why could I not hit you though? Yeah, I can finally begin hitting this guy. Ah, this guy was like wall glitched or something. Okay, I'll just let you drop down there then. And yeah, that area is full of water. I'm not exactly expecting to find anything, you know, in the watery depths, so I'm not exactly too eager to go there. But at the same time, yeah, you never know what you can find in the longshirt. I don't know what this longshirt does, so I'm just gonna keep it in my inventory until a later point in time when I can ascertain with greater certainty what it does. I'm just gonna override the save. Now, the next thing that I'm gonna do is go up here and I'm gonna rest. Try to rest, at least at a place where I can rest, if I can find such a place. Although that is far easier said than done. Of course, there are enemies nearby. What about some place over here? Still enemies nearby? Okay, I'm gonna top up this save here. For this dungeon, the theme that I'm matching is I'm using one slot for saves that are indeed safe and one slot for saves that are unsafe. So the slot that I saved on right now was the save slot. So this path we have already covered, we will be chancing upon the other side as well. We will be going up there. This is a dead end. Right then. So I guess we can just go ahead and completely explore this side then. Something that we neglected doing before. Because we went out in search for a place to rest, right? So wait, what is that blue glowing thing there? Oh, it's just flames. And that is the norm in these modules. So thus far, this is the only module that I've seen. Holy shit. Of course, I'm paralyzed. I did not expect that guy to pop out of nowhere, to be honest. Reaction, thank you. These guys are easy play now. After facing off against those big baddies, these guys are easy play. My god. That guy came out of nowhere. Nowhere, I tell you. Okay, you don't need to start now. Thank you. See? We already came back here. Like, this entire section just is a giant thing that goes around. And I'll just leave this here. Some blood. Let's see if... Yeah, let's go down this path here. Okay, maybe I should be picking up more stuff off the ground. And my enemies. Let me update that. Save. Checking corners, even though this is not an FPS. And checking corners will not help a bit. But checking them nonetheless. Because you never know what's gonna jump out of a corner at you. Like this guy here. My god. He almost scared me. Like, he did scare me. He actually did scare me. So, heal throw? Heal throw it is. Holy shit. What is this? Malachite. I thought that was like some sort of an ore, to be honest. I thought it was some sort of an ore. I'm gonna save on top of this lot, obviously. And we're gonna keep pressing forwards. I hear something very conscientious over there. Well, conscientious wouldn't exactly be the right word for it. More like objectionable. Save versus spell made. Good. I don't know how long that's gonna be true for, but save versus spell made for now. Resist fire. Huh. So the second spell that this guy used essentially got his own self killed. Good, good, good. That's the kind of encounter I like. Ones where I don't get damaged, but the opponents do. So this is where this guy came out of. I suppose we go down here. Just check what's behind this door. It's probably one of the ways down to, you know, the level down there that we were looking at. Seems pretty topsy-turvy though. Did not expect the path to be this topsy-turvy, but well, here you have it. Yep, told you. Who hit me with what? Hold up, hold up. What just happened? What just happened? I have no idea what just happened, but something just happened. I got hit by something down there. And yeah, let's just mark this section on the map. No need to actually go in there. But I'm just gonna mark this section on the map so that for later, you know, in case we ever get there later. That pyramid structure is one of those places where I don't like going, because you're like exposed from all sides. Oh, there's a ghost here. I almost did not see the guy. How did this guy hit so hard? My god. And what am I hearing right there? There are enemies nearby, of course. I can hear them being nearby, but yeah, this section. Yeah, this doorway isn't exactly one of the good doorways. You don't typically want to go down there. Of course, there are enemies nearby. Can I like move a few steps back and like rest in this alcove right here? Of course I can't, because there are still enemies nearby. How about here then? Of course not. In this room? Maybe? Fine then, we'll just rush onwards. Onwards into darkness. Clear, nothing here. Let me just go ahead and re-update the save here. Maybe should have saved over the other slot. I don't know what this guy was trying to do, but he was trying to do something. Body has no treasure. Maybe we can rest now. So that's what was keeping us from resting all this time. Blunt weapon has improved. Since we know this to be a safe area, I decided to go ahead and save there. Is that a rat that I hear? This, I suppose, is another one of the ways to go get down there. By the time the knight swings like twice at me, I've already hit her countless times. That's one of the advantages of improving your speed. I can hear rats. I don't know why, but I can hear some rats here. Okay, I'm gonna save in the emergency slot because that is exactly... Yep, we are out here again. And the reason I saved there is because I'm probably gonna die pretty soon. To whatever it is that hit me so hard, even the previous time around. Like, look at that! I have no idea who's hitting me right now, but somebody is. Somebody most definitely is hitting me. An electricity spell this time around? Okay, I have no idea who's hitting me so much, but I feel somewhat bad. Really? This should give me levitation to go down there. Should I choose to? But since we have explored this area and deemed it like pretty useless. Oh, there was a lich all the way up there, I see. I thought we took care of that lich. Apparently we did not. Apparently we did not. So this is just another one of the ways to go down. Which to me is useless because, well, I think there is like one extra room down there that we can access if required. But yeah, I'm not too eager to access it, so to speak. The ghost died. I think the ghost was trying to paralyze me. I see skull there. I feel somewhat bad. I have been poisoned. Alright, let's use a potion of cure poison. I was going through my inventory before this game and I noticed that I had like a ton of potions of cure poison. And I was just wondering, why do I even have so many potions of cure poison? Well, it's finally of some use right now, so. There's that. So I think we've come full circle to the very beginning of the dungeon, except for this little hidden door here. We can probably go check out whatever that is. Is it here? No, just a few paces ahead. I think this is the hidden door. Ooh, that's a broad hidden door. I don't know why I'm checking my corners like that, but... Levitation, reaction, resist fire. Alright. Let's go assault this guy. I mean, even though this is just a lich, but still. You know what? Yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and use my magic items to unfreeze myself. For example, these boots, and I'm gonna use them. The lich just died. There's another lich here though. And we do want to be killing him too. I just need to heal myself first. One thing that I'm glad about is the fact that Heal True still heals me to the maximum amount. I think that's like all the enemies there are in this, you know, little section. I don't think there are any more enemies, but I'm still gonna save in the emergency slot in case there are. I think the rest of them are behind locked doors. Now here's to hoping that the thing that we're looking for... Ooh, Dwarven Gauntlets. But Mithril is better. Which is sort of strange because Mithril means Elven. I feel like I've said this before. But Mithril means Elven. Mithril is things of Elven make. But for whatever reason... Dwarven is better than Elven, but Mithril is better than Dwarven. And if memory serves me, there should be like a hidden door here. No? Oh well, okay. I'll go and resave on this slot. Because I'm gonna be doing a little stunt right now. Wraith died. Now, the pyramid structure, I don't like going down there, but... it just... has this one particular part, you know, this one area with, well, the quest objective in it, which is, well, the most annoying thing about it, to be honest. But, oh well, it is what it is. If we need to go check it out, then we need to go check it out. There's no other way around it. Okay, now... we took a left earlier. Maybe this time around we can take this right here and check out whatever there is on that side. The pyramid is something that I want to head to last. I don't want to go to the pyramid. I'm in no hurry to get to the pyramid. checking my corners. There's a rat there. I wonder why there's a rat there. Am I getting close to the objective? And a skeleton! Look at the skeleton! No, my god. That is amazing. I caught a skeleton. Of course not. This is just a dead end. So, I think now that we have cleared this entire section, I wonder if there's anything more left to explore here? Well, except for whatever was down there, you know, downstairs, I mean. So this section comes to an end, that takes me there. Where else? Are there any branches that have been left unexplored? I think there are if we, like, actually care to take a look at it, but that leads to a dead end. Okay, that takes us down there. That is how we get there. This leads to a dead end. That is the way to the, you know, room at the very bottom. That is also an inconsequential room. That is a dead end. And that also takes us to into the very middle, the heart of the triangle. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna head there and I'll bring out my bow and arrow, and in a very rare occasion I'm gonna try and just get as many of these people as possible. Ironically, I don't think I've seen any underwater sections yet. I wonder what that thing is. Anyway, and I don't really think I'm missing anything here. That's literally the entrance to the dungeon. This was the only way to come here, so I think I've covered all my bases, as well as can be covered, at least. From the looks of it. That area also leads to a dead end. Yeah, it seemed to be the case, yes. Alright, so we're gonna go to the balcony now and shoot out any and all objectionable hooks that might dare stand in our way. Which way was the balcony again? Yeah, we take the first right. Okay, wish me luck. I'm gonna save in the emergency slot in case something happens. Yeah, I wanna equip this. Remove my bow and arrow and equip this. Equipping longbow. Left hand, equipped. Right hand, equipped. But this will of course not have as great of a damage output as, well, the rest of, you know. Oh, I think there are two of them there. I honestly don't know where I'm shooting, to be honest. I'm just certain that I'm shooting at something. So yeah, this will not have as much damage as an ebony bow, but like or an ebony or a dwarven bow, or dwemer bow for that matter. But yeah, used to hoping that it actually does some damage. I think I'm hitting somebody, I'm not sure. I feel like it might just be better to equip my weapons and just go out there and rush them. Because when we made that cursory sweep of whatever was down there, we did not exactly find anything. And I'm afraid that I might be hitting something that's not even there, to be honest. How many arrows do we have left? 30? Okay, let's pop out a potion of levitation. We have levitation spells down there, but yeah, we were just shooting it. How did you manage to paralyze me from that far? Answer me. Answer me this. I thought I was hitting somebody. That's when you get the sound. This sort of sound. Like, you know? The sound of actually hitting somebody. So, I thought I was getting that sound, but... So, this guy's out of spells now. This poor guy is out of spells now. Let's go ahead and, yeah. Let's, pull out a little hack that we like to use. And, equip this and this. I've got only 16 arrows left, and I intend to put them to better use than this. Mace and Tower Shield, equipping, left hand equipped. Right hand equipped. Right then. Well, I don't know if you're still alive or not, but I hope you're dead. Potion of invisibility. Well, too bad I'm a warrior. No, I do want to keep equipping that. One and a... almost a quarter to 2 kilograms. Now, here's the thing, when you're diving off these platforms, you just need to be a little careful, otherwise... I'm just gonna use this opportunity to get down here. And see if there are still any objectionable contents here. I think the Lich, he essentially just falls and dies, you know? I'm just gonna, like, run about the area. That's an orc. That's an orc. I wonder if for Watcher there was an orc there. I'm just essentially running about the area. That door opened. That door was not open initially, but that door opened now. Yeah, I'm just essentially checking to see if there are any, you know, enemies there that I need to be aware of. Because most certainly we have to come here. This is most certainly the correct, way to go. Alright, so which were the areas where we, you know, had mapped out initially? So this entrance we did not know of. That is one of the entrances that we knew of. And where was the other entrance? That's another one of the entrances that we know of. Which leaves us with two entrances, the one behind us and the one to our right. So which one should we choose first? I suppose I'll update the slot number 4. Although I think that's a bad idea, but I'll go ahead and do that. Yeah, this room is nothing. Just a resting room of sorts at most. Cool. So I'll resave here, since this is a known safe area. And that leaves only one place for us to go. And if our quest objective is not there, then we're gonna have to essentially take a little bit of, you know, go on an exploratory adventure. Should I save you? Nah, I just saved. Okay. Okay. I see what's gonna happen. Resist fire. I do have sufficient potions of resist fire, thankfully. But the real kicker is that after doing all of this, I'll need to go back to... what's her name? Medora in the Direnni Tower, just to... give her, you know, her potion, like, whatever this is. The dust of Restful Death back to her. Like, after all of this. Which sort of, you know, always makes me wonder whether this is worth it or not. I think this is just another room. Yes, it is. Doesn't hurt to check, though. Good. While the potion of resist fire is still active, I'll try to capitulate on that fact and proceed onwards. I see another one of you guys there. Cool. You died. Thank you. Thank you so much. What would I have done if had you not died? I cannot speak today. Maybe it's because it's like 2 o'clock in the night or something. Alright, time to sleep. Time to sleep until we get fully healed. My stealth has improved. I'll save you. I'm guessing my stealth has improved because, well, I've been in the vicinity of enemies who have had no idea that I'm even there. Now, what's gonna piss me off is if I actually have to go into the underwater section up ahead. Okay, two more bots. Let's go downstairs then. I was wondering, how are these areas so small? Not two bots, it's just one bot. My bad. My bad. Okay, it's a lich. That guy hit hard, but he also died from his own explosion, so I'll give him a pass. Okay, time for me to start moving back again. Remind me to just go ahead and use the Jade Emerald. You know. Like the Jade of Protection next time onwards, whenever I see one of these guys. I feel like that might actually be useful. Because right now all I'm doing is running to the safe room and back, and that's literally all I'm doing. Very, very strong enemies in this level. Now we can go upstairs, we can stick to the same level. Eventually we're gonna have to explore all of it anyway. Oh, okay, so this is where we come out. That's nice. There's another way down there and a way forward. Let's check out the way down first. Thankfully, I wanna use this Jade of Protection. This thing that casts a shield. Of course I'm paralyzed. Okay, let me just go ahead and heal myself first. And then I'm gonna go ahead and use the boots, the unrestrainable tall boots. Wait, what are these again? Of course, enhancing dragonish. I have no idea what this does. First I'm gonna use these boots, and then I'm gonna... Maybe I should start using that. Maybe I should just start using that. I dislike how I was missing half those shots. You know what they say, right? You miss half the shots that you don't take. Well, I was taking all those shots, but I was still missing. And, yeah, that's something to dislike. It really is. I feel like the quest objective might just be in the underwater area, to be honest. Okay, this was a little detour. We should probably keep going towards the right. No, that's where we came from, so towards the left. No, the right. I'm gonna save here, because we are in the field right now. Well, just when I was hoping that it would not be a long-ass module again, well, my hopes have been proven wrong. Who knows, maybe it could lead us to where we need to go. Who knows, right? So I'm gonna save the game here, just because I have a bad feeling about this. And let's see where it leads us. This little incursion of ours. Probably this door here. Really? Of all the people to be paralyzed by, this guy here. Never would I have thought that I would ever be paralyzed by this here guy. Come on, YouTube. Yeah. The Four Sons. And that was like a pretty short paralysis spell to boot. Not a large spell at all. Like, not a long paralysis spell. Oh no, it's like another one of those. Oh well. Let's see. At least it's just a ghost. Do I hear a date residue, sir? I sure hope I don't. Okay, so we have covered the other side as well, so let me just drop a flower here. And, well, I do know that there is something in the underwater section over there. Like, there's like a faint mass of land wherein you can actually go and find things, but, well, it's a hassle, to be honest. It really is a hassle. So yeah, we've already gone there. We've gone down there as well. That's a dead end. Let's see if there's anywhere else left that we have to go yet. So wait, that's the only way to go? Have we entirely covered the cave systems here? For the most part, it seems to be the case, yes. Okay. It's also strange, I actually found some pieces of gold in my inventory, like actual pieces of gold that were not counted as, you know, the amount of gold that I had, but just pieces of gold floating about in my inventory. Okay, so since we have covered all of these areas, I do believe we have. Let's see here. I mean, this is one section which, hold up, it's up there. Yeah, if we go up here, it joins up to this stone right here. And that's the path we took. I just want to check if there's any other diversion there that would lead us elsewhere. Not from the looks of it, no. I think we have covered everything. Like, everything that this cave has to offer. So I guess the only place left is the underwater areas. Oh well. Here we go then. I like the fact that this dungeon module isn't as large. Water walking and water breathing. I like water walking more than water breathing. Okay, so there are two parts here. That's a mermaid, I think. It's the first time I've seen Lamia. I see. I doubt the dust will be anywhere underwater, but just to check and confirm. Yeah, so this actually leads you out into another section. So, okay, so this section is empty. Nothing here. Typically, a lot of times, you might find the quest objective in, you know, in areas just beyond the reach of these underwater sections. But not in this case, apparently. Excuse me. Oh, right. Can I go up there, perhaps? Check around the fringes? No? Okay. So, you don't typically need potions and spells of water walking in this game. So I do feel like we have explored both these sites quite optimally and turned up empty-handed. So the only place that I can think of searching right now is, well, have we opened this door? Of course we haven't. We have not opened this door, but we have searched it though. That is for sure. But down there. I guess we'll just have to go down there then. Saving in the emergency slot because I don't know what else to do. And water breathing and water walking. I suffered some damage. Like, there are slaughter fish in this area, I know that. Can you, like, just die quickly, please? Thank you. I don't have all day, you know? Yeah, these areas are not beginner friendly. Like, this is literally an ambush point. Like, when... I think that's the laugh of a Lamia. I think that's what I keep hearing. The laugh of a Lamia. Magically held dock. Right. So, can I perhaps use my... undeniable access to open this. Oh, right, I keep forgetting that. Right, if... like, these will typically just raise these platforms. Where did you come from? And come on, if you want to attack me that bad. I think what we're supposed to do is essentially... the proper way to use these is to essentially... oh, well, I was trying to open the Lamia, is it? The Lamia. Lamia. Can I not? I'm too far away. Am I too close now? What's going on? Thank you. At least I could do this much. 330 gold pieces. And let me just go ahead and flick the switch on. That's literally all I want to do. Okay, now that since I have this, let's use a potion of water breathing at least. And maybe a potion of water walking as well, because... yeah, it gets boring pretty quick without it. Again, a magically held block. So I was basically supposed to hit the switch, which, you know, lets me slow fall. No, I want to use it. I tend to forget that a lot. In most cases, these doors, they tend to have, you know. Right. Yeah, use. Spell effect failed. There's Lamia behind it. Again. I doubt there's anything of significance in there, but I'm just going in to check nonetheless. I doubt I'll find the treasure anywhere here. Which now beckons the question, where could the damn thing be? There's a ghost here, but I wonder how he's like trapped all the way down there. I've been to all four places, but I did not find a switch. Oh. No, wait. I did not find a switch in this room. Which makes me wonder, does this room have a switch anywhere? That's supposed to open the fourth and final trapdoor then. The room towards the north. It should... ah, yes, right here. Yes, it's typically supposed to have some or the other kind of switch. And that's just how these places are structured. Typically, they don't really have anything of import, though. Is something that I will say. They typically... excuse me, can I just... please... thank you. I would like to use a potion of levitation. If I have one. Apparently I do! Am I levitating? Well, apparently I am. But I'm also swimming, so... that apparently makes levitation a little difficult. Okay, so there was nothing down there. So where am I supposed to go then? Where am I supposed to go and what am I supposed to do? Okay, let's review the map. We have been there. That path takes us down there. We have... been through that path, and we have come up this side, which takes us to like a rest area of sorts. You know, it's at times like these when I just want to hit Tele 2 quest marker and be done with it, but then again, since I have gotten rid of most of the enemies in this level, I know it's not really gonna be a hassle anymore. It's just a matter of roaming around until we find it, so... yeah, I mean, it is... the mystery is half solved right here. Any turns we might have missed? Not by the looks of it. I'm guessing that the only place where we haven't completely explored it is the cave section. Oh wait, what is this? No, that's just a dead end. Got my hopes up there for a second. Have we missed the loot anywhere? And we're back. But as you might have noticed, we are outside of the dungeon instead of inside it, and there's a very good reason for that. So I thought that the quest might have been bugged, and so I actually went over to USB Wiki, and yeah, there was like a section for this quest about, you know, bugs that I remembered. So when I went there, it revealed something to me. You guys remember that one mummy that we ate off the balcony? Okay, I'll just let you drop down there then. Yeah, that one mummy. So that mummy essentially is the one that actually carries the dust of Restful Death, for those of you who have not played this game before, which I doubt most of you would have already. So unfortunately, I have none of you to warn me about it, not that I'm live streaming either, so that's another thing. But anyway, that sort of makes up for the experience of playing Daggerfall for you. So yeah, we're gonna have to redo this quest. But since quest locations are decided before we ever get inside the dungeon, the mummy should still be there and we just need to make a beeline for it. So, wish me luck. Here's to hoping that the lich isn't here. Yep, just a ghost. That's good. Cool. We need to take a right here. And I'll be overriding the save. And that is not the way to go, this is the way to go. We'll continue on this way. I just hope to not run into an ancient lich, to be honest. That's my only hope. So, to that effect, I'm gonna keep overriding my saves. And this is the way to the base. I think it was this one. Of course it was not, it's just a ghost here. This was the way to the damn thing. Yep. Okay, so I'm gonna save in the emergency slot here, because, well, why not? See, the mummy sort of gets glitched again, so what I need to do is hopefully get it in a way. Oh no, yeah, see, that's what I was worried about. So once they get eaten off the balcony. Oh no! Okay, fine, again. I sort of saved over that spot there. I'll just cut to when I. Oh wait, I have a more recent save, don't I? Nope, not this. This one. So this should essentially be the same thing. I'm just gonna. Okay. Good for you, I guess. I'm just reading about all boots. Anyway, so where were we? Yes. Going towards the damn mummy. Problem is, the mummy can see you from far away, and. What I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna equip the bow and arrow. Hopefully that way the mummy won't fall off the edge when I hit it. Like, this is another way. I mean, I like the fact that that guy's like just wasting spells at this point. And yeah, that's the dust that we want there. That's all. Parchment, I guess we'll equip this? Okay. I guess not. So let's make a beeline towards the exit now. And this sort of simplifies the quest for us. Actually, we're going the wrong way. Excuse me, let me move. I would like to escape this dungeon, thank you. In one piece, hopefully. Yes, this is the way. I did not expect that lich there. That ancient lich. I did not expect him there. Okay, maybe this might not be such a bad place to rest up. And I'm just gonna save the game here. And I'm gonna equip my traditional weapons. Time to run. Not this. This one. Nope. Okay, time to go to the Direnni Tower. Now this did simplify the quest for us greatly in one way. More than a way, actually. Really? Oh yeah, there's an island to cross. Anyway, so anyway, we are now headed into the Direnni Tower, and we do have all the potions of levitation that we might need. So I'm just going to override this dungeon savior, and let's go back through the hordes of skeletons, out for our lives. Even though Medora has apparently gained her freedom, this is still like a persistent problem. We can't seem to get a break, can we? 60 gold pieces, and ooh, this is nice. I'm gonna carry that. Since this might just be a better idea, let's just save it. Anyway, we have to like get rid of these vampires here. And yeah, we need to head upstairs to activate both the flywheels, because this flywheel here is going to open up. Thank you. This flywheel here is going to open up the door for us. The door, you know, we'll have to use should we be unable to rely on the trapdoor to exit. And should we be, you know, forced to use the teleporters instead. But, yeah, let's hope that we can just use the trapdoors. Now, I'm gonna rest here for a... not rest here per se, but I'm gonna save here. Because this dungeon also does have... well... its own share of vampire ancients and liches that need to be able of. That opens the trap door at the base. Where did you come from? Wherever he came from, he died, so that's good. So now that we need to head down here, I'll just gonna... yeah, I'm gonna update the save here. And I'm gonna pop in a potion of Resist Frost. Well, cheat the protector as well. And a potion of Resist Frost. Heal true levitation. This is not frost, this is fire. No, where? Yeah, right here. Of course, I've been paralyzed. Thank you for coming and thank you for dying. Is this better than my bow? Nah, adamantium. Not at all better. Okay, so that calls for a save, and yeah, let's update this save here. I hear some objectionable entities here and there, but I would rather not engage them, to be honest. Now we come out of here, and I think we need to go up the steps. Yes, right here. We go up the steps. And I'm just gonna save here. Again, since I can. Since this experience thus far has been pretty good. And right as we were talking about this thing here, it just shows itself to us. Potion of... yeah, let's get healed first. That was a good decision on our part. Open to paralysis, we can try that on him, but for now I would rather like to use a potion of resist shock right here. And let's buy Jade the Protector as well. So vampire ancients, you'll find lots of them in this game, and they are mean. They are mean. I wonder what this does, the insert key. It just makes me look up a little. I wonder what use it is. Yeah, well, I don't exactly want to engage you, but since you're in my bed, let's just get it over. I'll take any gold that you might have, thank you. And I'll update this here safe. Let's
grab whatever you have, and let's take things a little slower instead of rushing through this. Oh no. Well, I mean, excuse me. Let us use this as well. Okay, time to heal up again. Fighting these guys is difficult. And good thing that I have a potion of resist shock, otherwise it would have become even more difficult fighting these guys. I didn't even hear when that guy came up from behind me, you know? There are enemies nearby, of course there are. Let us update the save again. And take things a little slow. No need to rush all the way. I'm not gonna stop with that individual, but what I will do here is go this way and... No, not this way, we take a left here. Yes. I hear another one of those guys. We need to go straight. Yes, we need to go straight. And at this juncture, we take a left. Of course, I cannot rest here. Maybe can I like rest here somewhere? Nah. Should I just pop in a potion then? Because finding a proper resting spot is going to take a lot of backtracking. So might as well just pop in a potion and save the game here. So now we take a left and we go to the very end of this doorway. Yes, this door here is what we are looking for. And this door will lead us to where we want to go. That's a raid that we got the jump on. Should be more raids here. But I'm not really too eager to, you know, spend my time fighting them. What I want to do instead is come this way. There should be a ghost here, right here. We got the jump on the ghost as well, and this is one of the levers that we want to activate. This is the other one. I just wish willpower actually did something good in this game, you know? Protector and resist fire. Potion of resist frost, frost, fire. I need a potion of resist fire, not frost, right here. I wish potions and things would stack in this game instead of, you know, being the way that they are. I cap the ghost knees. The raid sneeze. And here is the guy that we need to demolish. Lich died. Cool. Do you have anything I can carry with me? 855 gold. I'll take that. I'll take that indeed. I'll rest in front of Medora here. Yeah, I think I'm in a safe place. Time to save here. And this is indeed the dust of restful death. As for that letter, it was from Gortwog to me, though I never got it. I see. I hear from him later that his orc warriors were slain attempting to ambush the assassins. Gortwog and his orcs are not the villains most people seen them as. Edvir and the court of Varys have never been particularly loyal to the Empire. To assassinate a king is treason. I will have my revenge. But first I must find out why Edvir would risk this. I need a month to prepare the dust. Come back to me, and at that time I will give it to you, along with instructions for its use. But here's the thing, I actually totally forgot to read the letter. So let's load the save up again. Let me just read the letter and then hand it back in. miscellaneous, yes. We just got a roll for that letter. A lot of scrolling because, well, the scroll wheel doesn't work in this game either, so you need to scroll per click. Like, you can't even hold down the scroll button and expect it to keep scrolling, you know? I think this might be it. Use? Nah, not this. This one. This parchment was used as a wrap for the package of powder. Some of its message is now illegible. Lady Med. Medora? Wall. Wall. Wall, and that's it? Nothing else? Fever. Okay. They intend to slay him. I am sending Urs to stop them. You must support me. If the Empire finds I have attacked royal advisors of Beerus, presumably, then if they are assassins, my people will never win the same status and respect as the Khajiit, presumably, Ishans. However, with your support, I a hero of the Empire and win respect for my people, Gortwog. So it just gives you like randomized, you know, messages every single time. Okay. Alright, now then, since we have done that, let us save here and head back. Hopefully we won't find much resistance along the way, and we can just head back peacefully. I hear another vampire ancient that I'm not eager to face off against. A vampire that I had not seen on the way here. Since I cannot carry more items, I'll just leave her be. That's a wraith. I do suppose this is the way to go. Told you there are more wraiths here. Cool. I think there's like another wraith there, but I'm not gonna, you know, stop and fight it. I'm running past everything. As far as I can run. And we keep running until we find where we came from. Oh no, wait. We came from here, I do believe, yes. Although this way might have been shorter, but still. I mean, it's not like a sure shot success going that way, I mean. Sometimes it works, sometimes it does not. And you never really know when it's gonna work and when it's not gonna work. I still haven't figured out what creatures make those sounds. I think those are or lemurs, but I'm not entirely certain. Levitation. Now, can we get levitation? I do believe I had like at least one potion of levitation. So this is the way up, I do believe. No, that's the way up. Right. And this is the way we must take to get back out of the dungeon. No, no, I do not want to stay in the Direnni Tower, especially with that thing howling in my ear. And that was that. I mean, my second incursion into this here place was pretty nice. It was far better executed than the first time around. But the first incursion was, it was rough. I mean, I was supposed to find the dust on the mummy and I kept exploring the entire place like a madman. Even after recording, actually, that's what led me to actually go over to, well, yeah, let's go back to Calibria. So yeah, that's actually what led me to go to the UASP wiki, because I kept searching everywhere for, you know, some place to get to so that I can actually I literally like searched all the places, but I came up empty-handed. So that being the result, that being the reason why I decided to essentially just where am I going again? Northeast, right? I consult USB wiki because I could not find the dust anywhere. And I later found out that it's supposed to be on a mummy. And I remember that the only mummy that I'd seen throughout the entire dungeon was the one that we had eaten off the balcony. I mean, if you ask me personally, I would say it's lazy game design, but well, can't really be helped now, can it? It is what it is. So, I mean, that's just how this game was designed. So, I mean, we just need to wait until, like, we just have to retry these dungeons. And I was talking with a guy on Reddit, and it was, the guy said something that was pretty hilarious, that it's strange that for a game, we need to create things like, you know, emergency seed slots and use similar ideas. And these things are usually applauded as, you know, good ideas to you know, implement into your personal gameplay. And yeah, I mean, that's pretty much the entire experience of playing Arena, Daggerfall, to be honest. Create save slots and stick to them, because otherwise the game is gonna, you never know when you're gonna get fucked over in this game. So you better stick to the save slots that you create, and create lots of them. You have no other option if you wanna play it safe. A save before picking up a quest, a save, well, before entering a dungeon, which is what saved me in this case. Otherwise, I did not have any other save slots remaining. So maybe I should be a little more cautious about that in the future as well. This is a good sword, but I already have, I believe, a better sword, which would be this one here. Oh no, not that. Where's my katana? My Daedric katana. Right here. Yep, better sword. This shop usually has pretty good loot. I've heard that there are other shops in Daggerfall that have got better loot. Ooh, I sold it to him and he's already put it up on display. That's very nice of him. Anyway, I just keep looking here and there in case there are like some pieces of armor that I can use perhaps. But yeah, that's not always the case. There's also like, I think there's another rack up there. Anyhow, I'm sort of getting sidetracked here. This video is probably has been going on for pretty long for you guys. For me, this was my second login session and I knew exactly what to do and where to go. Because of, you know, past experiences and all the headaches that I had to suffer yesterday, which most of you haven't seen yet. So anyway, this is it for today's video. And this was gathering our quest to gather the Dust of Restful Death for, well, what's his name? Medora, so that she could put Lysandus' ghost to rest. Now, when we come back, we will be covering, we will be attempting to cover, can we advance a rank in the fighter skill yet? I do not think we can. I do not think we can advance a rank in the fighter skill yet. So I suppose we'll just leave it at that. I suppose, yeah, it has, I don't think it has been like a month yet. You don't allow like a promotion in a month. So, okay, so when we come back, we will actually be covering Elisena's betrayal. We'll basically answering the summons that we received from Elisena, the other letter that I showed you guys, which I'm gonna have to crawl down quite a bit for to find out for you guys. So I'm not gonna do that right now. So yeah, when we come back, we will be covering Elisena. We will be responding to Elisena's summons, and yeah, let's see what happens after that. The quest is titled Elisena's betrayal, so I'm pretty sure you guys can gather what's gonna happen. At any rate, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. Until next time, fare thee well, fellow Earthlings.